Hi, my name is Yariv Dror and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Storia.com. After spending over $10 million on Google AdWords, I would like to share with you in this video how to set up and optimize such campaigns. I will start with the basics and then disclose some great tips for those who run or want to run an AdWords campaign by their own. I will finish with more tips for those who rather find an automatic solution to run their AdWords campaign for them. Setting up an AdWords campaign requires the following: choosing the most relevant advertising method, designing the most effective campaign structure, conducting a keyword research, creating the ads whether text ads or banners, deciding on the most suitable landing page for each of the ads, adding negative keywords, defining the budget for each campaign and setting up the bids for each ad group, and finally, implementing tracking and reporting codes in order to enable optimization. Well, it might take a bit longer than 5 minutes, but let's dig deeper. Choosing the relevant advertising method. Google offers a search network and a display network. Search ads will show your ads to people who are actively searching for what you are offering. Display ads will show your ads to people who are browsing sites with relevancy to your ads, sites that have dedicated some of their real estate for presenting Google ads. Display is much cheaper, but it's also less engaging and often yields less results. So, in this video, we will discuss search only. Search campaigns can be static or dynamic, leading to your site or triggering a phone call to your business, showing text ads or a combination of text and images if you are using shopping ads. Now, let's discuss how to design the most effective campaign structure. An AdWords account contains campaigns which let you control over your budget, geo-targeting, language, and scheduling. Ad groups which let you control the bids you wish to put on each group of ads. And at the end of the structure, you have the ads which can be text, banners, or a combination of text and image. Each ad can redirect to a different page within your site. A good structure is one that will enable you to optimize and run A/B tests for each of your business important segments and see what works best for your business. It could be a different product or categories, different demographies or geography, or different advertising methods that you want to run with. Keyword research requirements. When using the regular static search ads, the keywords serve as the trigger that prompts your ads. What you want to do here is to balance between the relevancy of the keywords and the price, which is determined by the competition. If you are selling a product that you have named, its name might not be known and searched for. If you are selling a branded product like iPhone, that name will cost you. What you want to do is come up with phrases often called as the long tail, which will describe the product properly and lower the cost per click as they will let you avoid competition at least to some extent. Make sure not to use too many words in each phrase though, as such phrases might not be searched for too often. Each keyword can also get a matching type like exact, phrase, or broad. And you also can define negative keywords such as free in order to sharpen the traffic your ads are displayed to. Let's talk about your ads. The typical static text ad has the following limitations. The headline can have up to 25 characters. The two description lines and the display URL can have up to 35 characters each. Normally, you will be paying per click on your ad. So what you want to do is to balance between getting only targeted potential customers from the one hand and having a poor click-through rate that will increase your payment per click on the other hand. To get the most targeted customers, you will want to tie up each ad with the most relevant keywords and landing page for the specific product or service you are offering. You will also want to prevent the usage of free offering or anything of that nature, which will attract people who are not looking to pay for your offering. On the other hand, you will want to have your ad containing a clear call to action and some numbers, symbols, and a capital letter for each word, all meant to increase your click-through rate. Let's move forward to landing pages. The landing page should be descriptive and enable the user to reach as quickly as possible to what he was looking for. If anything was promised at the ad, it should be provided at the landing page or at the page after that. To get a good quality score, which is a Google parameter that determines your cost per click, you would want to have the most relevant connection between the keyword, the ad, and the landing page that the ad leads to. So, you want to have the ad linking to a landing page that mentions the keyword a couple of times, in the right context of course, don't push it just for Google. Budgets and bids. You need to set budgets for each campaign and bids for each ad group. Budgets should balance the amount of money you are willing to risk with the number of products or services you are offering and with your time to market. From the one hand, you would want to start slowly and ramp it up once you are able to see performance and optimize the campaigns. On the other hand, the quicker you need the campaign to work for you and the more offering you wish to promote, the larger budget you will need to risk. As a rule of thumb, try to spend the cost of one product you are trying to sell times 2 or 3 over the first couple of days. If you can't get at least that and optimize from there, go back into the initial setup stages. As for bids, we will provide a way for balancing them shortly. Start with anything you feel comfortable with, normally less than the Google Keyword Planner tool suggestion, and increase or decrease according to the method we will discuss here in a minute. Implementing tracking and reporting codes to enable optimization. One of the most important things that every campaign has to have is eyes on its performance. You can implement AdWords pixel tracking or Google Analytics code. If you use Google Analytics, you can link it to your AdWords account or add a UTM parameter to each of your ads. But do not be like one of the 80% of our clients that don't track conversions at all. Getting clicks on Google is easy. This is what Google sells. You have to be able to track their performance in order to optimize your campaigns and make sure they are as profitable as they can be. So that was setup. Now let's talk about your daily optimization. I hope you like Excel as much as I do. Every segment we mentioned in the setup should be monitored and tested. If you sell in more than one country, which one works well for you and which one should be paused. Same goes for different categories and products and for different ads and keywords. If you have the time, what you want to do is run A/B tests for as many segments as you can. For example, try different ad text within the same ad group to see which text works better for the same products and keywords. The ongoing optimization, whether done daily or weekly, is much more time consuming than the setup. But it is also where you are monitoring your money and making sure that your ROI keeps on growing. Tips for running a successful AdWords campaign by your own. Enough with 101, let's talk business. The following tips can save 50% of your budget, a lot of your time, and even turn a losing campaign into a profitable one. Bid balance. Here's how you find the most effective cost per click bid. What you want to do here is find the balance that lets you spend the budget you have decided to spend. Provided, of course, that the budget is bringing you a positive ROI. Start with any bid. If you didn't spend your desired daily budget, increase the bid by 10% and wait a day. If you didn't spend the budget again, increase the bid again. If you have spent the budget, decrease your bid by 5% and check again the day after that. Keep on doing this, as budget and bids are influenced by competition, seasons, and other factors. So the right balance today might change over time. If you are techie, Google offers script you can develop to run this procedure for you. Dynamic ads. When I was introduced to this feature after many years of working with Google AdWords, it blew my mind. This method of running a search campaign on AdWords lets you choose the description line of your ads and then have Google making most of the rest. Google dynamically decides on who to trigger your ads to, what would be the ad headline, and to which page of your site the potential customer will be redirected to. This is an amazing feature to work with. What you want to do next is to exclude the search queries that worked well for you from the dynamic ads and add them to a regular static campaign. This will make Google exploring more keywords for you while you try to get better bids for these well-performing keywords by bidding on them directly. Tips for not running an AdWords campaign by yourself. By this point, you are either thrilled with the new tips, which is great, or frustrated with the amount of work an AdWords account will require. I would like to reach out to those who are a bit frustrated and say, keep on doing what you love. If what I have said so far didn't make you thrilled about advertising on AdWords, outsource it. What you have just learned will help you work with an agency. There are good agencies that love what they do and do it right. They often charge a $1,500 setup fee and ask for a retainer of 3 to 6 months, but you can get good results. If you want recommendation for such agencies, we will be happy to provide you with such. For those of you who cannot afford an agency, we have a great automatic tool called the Traffic Booster that is doing everything mentioned in this video and then some using an algorithm that no human being can compete with. You are welcome to try it out. Thank you.